If you're a small business owner in 2025 and beyond, you are going to love Airtable if you are not already using it. So many small business owners have many similar problems, and Airtable can help you solve almost all of them. It is that one Swiss Army knife software that can come in and help you organize your business. And in this video, I'm going to be doing something a little unusual for my channel. Rather than going in and building an exact use case for you, I'm going to talk at a high level what Airtable can do for you and your small business. So, if learning more about how Airtable can empower your small business to new heights is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's my mission here with this channel to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools, and Airtable is our favorite no-code tool and pretty much has been for the last 7 or 8 years. So in this video, as I said, we're going to be talking about how Airtable is really a vital piece of software for almost every small business owner. And so if you are struggling to find a way to streamline your operation and get everything organized, you are going to love this because we're going to be breaking down what Airtable can do for you. Now, before we get into the heart of the video, though, I first want to invite you to join me for a crash course. I've built an Airtable crash course and it teaches you the basics of Airtable. So if you are a little stuck, you're not really sure where to get started, it's going to tell you all the key features that you need to know. And it's perfectly free or completely free. We will share it with you via email if you sign up at gapconsulting.io/Airtable-crash-course. And this is, over a few days, you're going to get emails from us that talk about the different key features of Airtable. So stay tuned for that if you want to learn more about Airtable. But without further ado, let's get into the heart of this video. What do small business owners need to know about Airtable and why is it so important for your small business growth? So to kick things off, let's paint the picture for what most small business owners are experiencing. Usually a small business is duct taping together a number of different software that is just a mess, right? You might have your CRM, you might have your inventory tracker, you've got your accounting system over here, you've got your HR system, all these different components, and usually they're not really talking all that much to one another. Maybe you've built some light automation that takes information from one place to the other, and that's great if you have, but most small business owners aren't really at that level yet. And furthermore, all this data is siloed. Your payment data is siloed in one place. Your CRM data is siloed somewhere else. You've got data in these different boxes and none of it's talking. So you don't have a clear picture. Not to mention your costs, right? Let's talk about the costs that you incur when you're running 4, 5, 6 different key software for your business. I mean, you're paying $100 a month or more for each of these different software and they all add up. Airtable can come in and wipe that slate clean for you. So if you ever found yourself saying, there's gotta be a better way than this, this is it. Airtable is a software that allows you to build your own solutions for whatever you need. And it's a database, yes, in the cloud, but it also has front-end interfaces as well. So you can share things with your team or with external stakeholders, show only the information that you want them to see, allow them to edit what you want them to edit, but ultimately lock down your data as well so that your operations run smoothly and people don't muddy it up with bad information. So this is like really the core to any business, is systematizing and making streamlined processes so that you can do more work. Most small businesses fail not because they can't get more clients, but because they don't have a streamlined way of delivering their service or product. And so Airtable can help you do exactly that. So let's start off by talking about some high-level use cases. And these are things that you can absolutely build in Airtable. And in fact, we've actually put together some templates on our website as well. So if you're interested, go ahead and swing by our website and grab those. It's another free resource that we offer. But let me just talk about some of those templates at a high level so that you know what you can even build with Airtable. So one thing is obviously a CRM. Having people fill out information, some sort of intake form, maybe you're just keeping track of the people that you meet as it relates to or as they relate to the different companies, right? So you might work with clients, you might be in B2B, business to business, but you are wanting to keep track of the people that you know that work for those businesses and the different interactions that you've had with those people and all the different ways that that information interrelates. Here's the thing, there's plenty of CRM systems out there that you might want to use, but you're going to pay for them specifically for that CRM. Most likely you're not going to use all the features that come with that CRM, so you're paying for stuff you don't even need. And ultimately, if you're going to wind up using Airtable in another part of your business, you don't incur additional charges for the different databases that you build in Airtable. So if you're using it already and you have an Airtable license, you might as well be using it in multiple areas of your business. Airtable is one of the only software that allows you to do that. And sure, maybe you say, well, hey, I could build a spreadsheet, but let's be real. We all know the problems with spreadsheets, broken formulas, poor collaboration. You never know if you're working in the right version or not. Like spreadsheets, there's a reason that they don't run small businesses efficiently. Airtable can step in where a spreadsheet drops the ball, but it also eliminates things like a CRM. Another key thing that Airtable can do is handle your operations and delivery. So you can track all of your operations, where things are within the process. If you're doing any service delivery or physical good delivery, you can track all of that information in Airtable, building essentially a solution that allows your team or you to tell people where their order is, when it's gonna ship, where is the information that they're looking for. All of it can interrelate in your operations and delivery database. We've also got the ability to build project management. So if you are doing any kind of services delivery, you need to keep things on track, you're on a schedule, on a calendar, you're assigning tasks to people, you need to collaborate in your app. Project management is one of those very common use cases for Airtable as well. Another big one that we see with our clients is in the billing and payments. Now, you've got a lot of options when it comes to billing and payments, but if you're doing any kind of sales online, you're probably integrating with something like a Stripe or a PayPal to collect that information, that payment information. Now, Airtable is not a payment processor, no, but it can store the data that's relevant to those sales transactions. If you're sending out invoices and you need to track where they are, if you are, selling digital products online, you can store the transactional data, the non-private stuff in Airtable and associate it with your clients. This allows you to see what your lifetime value is per client, how much people have spent with you within a given time frame. You can build all kinds of different dashboards and really streamline your data analytics so that you have one place to go as the business owner to see, did you beat your sales from last month? Did you hit your financial targets that you set in place for last quarter? And not only that, but you can also build automation to talk to these third-party payment processors so that you're not manually putting the data into Airtable when you sell something. No, no. You just have a place that you go and it shows you that information as it relates to the other parts of your business. You can also build third-party documentation for PDF generation. You can create invoices automatically through tools like Document or Docs Automator, which are some third-party Airtable add-on options. Airtable is also great for storing scheduling information. So if you are using something like Acuity, Calendly, or Fillout, and you're getting people to book time with you, whether that is services sold, meetings that you're selling, consultations, however you're running your business, everyone's business is a little different, but you can store that information in Airtable. Imagine putting together some sort of scheduler or inquiry database solution where your team just logs in, they click and they know exactly where they need to be. They can take notes on that call, collaborate more effectively as a team. Everybody knows where everybody else is throughout the process. Seamless. So this type of scheduling solution can be deployed for your small business and really save you a lot of headache chasing stuff down and not knowing where the information is. And then one other very common thing with Airtable is forms for intaking data. You know, a lot of times people in small businesses are doing a lot of redundant data entry all over the place. I've seen many, many hundreds, if not thousands of clients copying data from one place and literally pasting it into another. And with Airtable, you can eliminate all of that redundant data entry. Put it in one time, or better yet, have your client put it in because you gave them a form. And once they fill that form out, that data lives in your Airtable at your fingertips. Whenever you need it, it's right there. And you can pull it up and access it easily. So let's round all of this out, right? And I know I said this in the beginning, but this is very different from our usual videos where we're showing you how to do stuff in Airtable. So if you're watching this and you're thinking this is too good to be true, check out some of those other videos because we show you how to do exactly these things on this channel. But let's wrap up this concept here. What are we talking about? One software that allows you to build all the different components of your business so that you're not getting nickel and dimed for every single different software you use. Eliminate all that extra software and have one software that does all those things. Your CRM, your HR, your billing, all of those components can be brought into Airtable so that all that data is in one place. So really think about Airtable like Lego building blocks for your business. Start in one place. Start solving one specific problem. Maybe it's your CRM, your lead flow, your inquiry, whatever it looks like in your business, wherever you're wanting to plug the gaps right now, start with that. Build a solution for that in Airtable, and then you're going to start seeing that it expands into other areas of your business. You'll start asking things like, should I be building something in Airtable to solve this problem or this problem? And before you know it, the answer is mostly yes, and you'll have built your entire business ecosystem around Airtable, which benefits you because it gives you more control over your data, and it means that you're not going into a dozen different places to find the answers you need to run and scale and grow your business. So how do you get started and where do you go from here? Listen, the truth is if I picked up Airtable today, I would feel a little bit overwhelmed. I've had the luxury of working in Airtable for over 8 years, doing a lot of client work, but the benefit of watching Airtable grow over the years has been a really strong one. I can't deny the fact that 8 years ago when I first found Airtable, it didn't have all the features that it has today. So if I started today, I would feel a little overwhelmed. Here's my core advice. Number one, grab the free crash course that I mentioned at the beginning of this video because we put it together for people like you with you in mind so that you could learn the basic key features of Airtable. That's number one. Number two is focus on the data layer first. Airtable has a lot of key features, or key functions. They have data, they have automations, they have interfaces, they've got forms. All of this is all readily available at the top of your Airtable screen when you're logging into Airtable. Don't start getting bogged down by all of that noise. My key recommendation is to instead focus on the data layer. Get your data talking first. It's gonna look like a spreadsheet. You might feel a little comforted by that, maybe not, but build the data layer so that your data is talking. So in the example of a CRM, you've got your contacts, you've got your companies, you have your interactions. Connect all these tables, build those tables so that they're talking to each other in one Airtable database. And once you have the data properly structured, then you can go playing around with your automations and your interfaces so that you can see the data that you need to see and so that you can streamline a lot of those operations without needing manual inputs. So those are my key takeaways. Of course, if you need additional help beyond what our channel offers, we do have a bunch of services at our website as well. But of course, before you get to the point where you're buying a course or training or consulting in Airtable, my key recommendation for you is to try it out. See what it can do for you. Because once you build something, even something small, you're gonna start seeing or feeling the wheels in your head turning. You're going to start thinking about other use cases for Airtable, new ways that you can implement it and get even more out of the software. And remember, you can build as many databases as you want on your Airtable plan. It's not going to incur additional costs for you. So once you get started, you'll be surprised at how quickly you ramp up to speed. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. I know, again, it was not our normal one, but I hope you enjoyed it just the same. If you want to see more content like this, be sure to subscribe to the channel and give this video a thumbs up. And if you have questions that we did not get to answer here, swing by our website. We have a ton of resources available for you there. Of course, most importantly, keep on building.